Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. This is your host, Dr. Wagner Pastor, the tenor principal vocal artist at Heartland Sings. Heartland Sings is a nonprofit organization located in Fort Wayne, Indiana. We offer several entertainment and educational programs such as concerts, voice, and piano lessons. Make sure to follow us on social media, and if you enjoy the show, please share it with your friends and family, because we are here to encourage people passionate about the vocal arts.
Heartland Sings inspires people of all ages and abilities through cultural and entertainment experiences, educational programs, and community outreach. Heartland Sings is changing lives through song. Heartland Sings inspira a personas de todas las edades y habilidades a través de experiencias culturales y de entretenimiento, con programas educativos y vinculación con la comunidad. Heartland Sings está cambiando vidas a través de la canción. Heartland Sings es una institución de interpretación artística que promueve la apreciación por las artes vocales para inspirar al público y artistas a través de experiencias excepcionales de cultura y entretenimiento con programas educativos y vinculación con la comunidad. Heartland Sings is a mission-driven performing arts institution that fosters an appreciation for the vocal arts, inspiring audiences and artists through exceptional cultural and entertainment experiences, educational programs, and community outreach.
Today, we have Ashlee Bickley McCrory, the vocal artist and developer associate at Heartland Sings and voice faculty at Purdue University Fort Wayne and the mother of two. How are you doing, Ashlee?
I'm doing really well. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you for being here. We appreciate your time sharing with us. So let's start from the beginning. Could you share a little bit about your background and specifically, how did you get interested in music?
Yeah, I'm from the Philadelphia area. And when I was in elementary school, I joined a children's choir. It's called Pennsylvania Youth Chorale, and it's still around. And being in that children's choir gave me some really great foundations of my music learning, and it made me really love choral singing. We sang all kinds of genres of music, like if you think about the types of music they sang here in the Fort Wayne Children's Choir. And I really loved it, and it made me realize that I wanted to be a singer in some capacity. So I started taking voice lessons. And then when I was in high school, I was an apprentice with an opera company called Bohem Opera New Jersey.
Oh, nice.
And that also still exists. So I sang in some opera choruses, and I fell in love with opera. And the piece that made me want to be an opera singer was the quintet from Carmen.
There you go.
And we are going to be performing that
yes.
in our recital
yes.
on November 5th. So anybody listening, if you want to hear the piece that made me want to be an opera singer, come see our recital November 5th.
Yes, don't forget to come November 5th at Prima Church.
Mm-hmm. At 4?
Yes, at 4 p.m. Mm-hmm. Great. And what was, besides opera, what was the kind of music that made you become a professional singer that you are?
Well, being an opera singer was really my dream, but I also, I've always loved Bach from that time in children's choir. So I like early music, I like oratorio, and also those foundations in children's choir made me a really good musician. A lot of singers come to singing because they love theater. And I came to singing because I love music, and singing is my chosen instrument. So I really like new music as well. New music not meaning contemporary, but new music kind of out there and written in the last 50 years and yeah, I think it's a lot of fun. But I also really like singing pop music and things too.
Yes, I love pop music. I love classical music. I think I love most of the music out there. And now that you mentioned contemporary music, It's so important to learn that kind of music, because if you know how to sing those contemporary operas, you can sing a lot and you get hired more often, because especially serialism or this more complicated music, it's not for everybody.
Yes, that is true. And actually, my first, I would say, big professional gig, as opposed to student level, early young artist level gigs, was a recital of composer submissions that I did with our very own Maestro Robert Nance.
Nice.
And it was very challenging. But we had a lot of fun with it, interfacing with those composers. It makes it more real when you're able to talk to the composer and hear their intentions. It's nice to have your own interpretation as a musician also, but it's really cool to collaborate with a composer, and those pieces were definitely challenging but very rewarding.
Yes, and I was just listening a podcast when I was driving this morning, and they said that the opera audience, and as cliche as it sounds, is dying. And it makes sense, because it's just an art form that has been there for years and years. And we love Verdi, we love Puccini, we love Mozart. But there are issues now in society that are addressed by these contemporary composers, like Fire Shut Up in My Bones. Oh my gosh, I love that new opera. And they just deal with issues like racism that before it was not even thought about it, or people didn't want to look at those issues, or immigration. So I'm glad I learned that you love this contemporary kind of art too. Now, would you like to share how and when your relationship with Heartland Sings began?
Sure. I moved to Fort Wayne, Indiana in 2012, which is, it's crazy to think that that was 11 years ago. But I was straight out of my master's degree, and my now husband was working at Fox Products Corporation, the double reed manufacturer in South Whitley. So he moved to Fort Wayne first for the job, and I then followed. And he worked with some other bassoonists at Fox Products. My husband's a bassoonist. If you love Heartland Sings, you may have seen him play at Spirit of Christmas. His name is Alex McCrory. So I met another bassoonist there at Fox named Mike Trinicosti. Again, if you love Fort Wayne musicians, you probably know him too. And Mike hooked me up with Bob. Bob was one of the first people I heard about in Fort Wayne that I should be contacting. And by Bob, I mean Maestro Robert Nance here at Heartland Sings. So I auditioned for Heartland Sings soon after moving here. And the rest is history. I've been singing with Heartland Sings on and off of the staff since then.
Wow, 12, 11 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Yeah, I've been here for like 9 months, 10 months now. And I like the city. And now that you mentioned that your husband is a musician too, it comes like some people in the company have met their partners or their spouses through music. Because Eric Miller has a wife that is a musician too. Natalie Young, her husband is a musician too. My wife is a musician. And they have told the story. Now, how did you meet your husband?
We met during our undergraduate degree at Eastman School of Music. We both worked in dining services. So he and I knew each other for 2 years before we were interested in each other. But once we began to be interested in each other, we didn't have the awkward kind of like asking for each other's contact information and whatever. Like, it just kind of like grew organically because we already had our numbers from trying to find substitutes for our shifts and the dining center and whatever. So we started IMing online, you know, when that was a thing, like AOL Instant Messenger. And then he had a problem with his computer, and he didn't want me to think that he was ghosting me. So then he like texted me like, hey, there's a problem with my computer. So then we started texting, and then we started talking on the phone. This was like over the summer. So then when we went back to the school, back to school in the fall, then everything just kind of fell into place.
That's a cute story.
What is your role at Heartland Sings? I know you wear a lot of hats here, so you can pick maybe two or three of them and you can elaborate on them.
Yeah, so primarily I'm a singer, and our lovely maestro, Robert Nance, reminded me not too long ago that he wants me to be a singer here, no matter the time commitment of those other hats. So number one hat is a singer, then a vocal artist. Then I'm also a teaching artist. Right now, I don't have a ton of students here at Heartland Sings because there are so many wonderful teaching artists. Listeners may have heard that we have some new teaching artists. So they have some openings in their studio. So if you want voice lessons, give us a call. And then I'm also a development associate. So I mentioned that I've been on and off of staff since moving here in 2012. And my first role on staff was as director of development. It was a part-time position at the time. I also had other part-time jobs. As you mentioned, I teach at Purdue Fort Wayne, and I was doing that then. And I also used to teach at Trine University. So I was also doing the director of development job amongst doing that. And it was becoming more and more apparent that Heartland Sings needed somebody full-time. So they found somebody full-time. So I did the development work for 4 years back then. And then that role became available again. And I was also still not looking for full-time employment, but I wanted to help. So I came back on as a grant writer. So I teach, I sing, I write grants.
Yeah, and you're really good at writing grants. And that's why we have all of these sponsorships. Yeah. And many more. Mm-hmm. And we're very thankful for all of those sponsors. And that leads me to another question. We have several patrons and donors, and we're grateful for it. Now, in this regard, for you, why is it important to support and promote the arts?
Well, you know, I knew you were going to ask me this question. And my first thought went to why should we monetarily support the arts. But then I was thinking about, like, why is it important to support and promote the arts in general? Like, why are the arts important? And recently, I've been more and more moved by poetry. We can look at a poem and know that the intent behind that poem was a certain circumstance or situation. But a lot of good poetry can be applied to the reader's life, and we find a lot of meaning in it, and a lot of the time we're really moved by that meaning. A lot of the people listening will probably think of a time that they've read a poem and cried, or wanted to cry, or laughed, or the thought of specific people or memories. And as singers, we get to sing poetry all the time. And adding music to that poetry moves us even more in those kinds of ways. And even if you take away that poetry, the music itself can move us in a lot of ways. I can think of a lot of times myself that I've been singing something, and if something is going on in my life, maybe I handle that situation or my thoughts or my feelings differently going about my life than I do when I'm interacting with music. Music just kind of reaches our soul in ways that other things can't. Talk therapy can't, or TV can't, although that is a different kind of art form. And same thing with visual art. It can stir up emotions or us personally tapping into or making visual art can stir up emotions in ways that other things can't. And it's important that we as people always connect to those things. And it is good to support the people making that art or the people facilitating that art or teaching that art so that we can continue to feel those feelings indefinitely.
Yes, you said it, Ashlee. It's important to support the art in general because, going back to Mozart, he used to write operas and compose symphonies because the royalty was supporting him. But at the end of the day, even back in those days with the greatest, they died poor. Artists are humans too, and we need to eat and we need to pay rent. For this reason, we have to focus not only on making the best that we can with music, with paintings, with food, with cinema, as you mentioned, with ballet, being conscious about all the effort that we are doing, and grants, donors, and the patrons that come to our show. And before we move to the last question, I want to ask you something else. What have been in your 11 years at Heartland Sings, your maybe two or three most memorable experiences with Heartland Sings?
Yeah, so you mentioned ballet, which is a funny coincidence because I think my most memorable moment with Heartland Sings was my very first concert when we did Carmina Burana with the Fort Wayne Ballet.
Nice.
And I think part of why that's memorable is that it was my first concert with Heartland Sings, but it was really moving for me as a performer. It was my first time singing Carmina Burana, but also singing a work like that in collaboration with dancers, it was just really meaningful, and I know that the concert goers really enjoyed it too. It was really great. Then another meaningful moment for me here at Heartland Sings was toward the end of when I was a principal vocal artist. In between my times doing development, I was a principal vocal artist. And we always do every year kind of like pop and jazz Christmas music for parties and things. And for a few years, we did that as a concert. And on my last one of those concerts, Ian, another former principal vocal artist, arranged Christmas Lullaby for Natalie and I to sing. And I had a baby, and Natalie was pregnant. Mm-hmm. And Christmas Lullaby is about having a baby. And it was really powerful for both of us. It was very hard for us to get through without crying, because we had to sing it at parties and in the concert and all kinds of things. By the time Christmas came, I think we could finally get through it without one of us crying. But it was usually me who was crying. But it was really meaningful, and I'm really glad I was able to sing that with Natalie. Also, I think my final memorable thing I will say is that we used to do jazz with big band, and that was a really cool experience as somebody who went to school for classical singing. To have the experience singing jazz with big band, especially when I didn't really know what I was doing. Bob really helped me a lot figure out how to sing jazz. I knew how to sing pop, so I started out singing jazz like I was Christina Aguilera.
Nice.
But I figured it out eventually. But it was really cool to sing vocal ensemble jazz with a big band.
That's exciting. I've never done that. I performed once when I used to live in Idaho with a pianist in a bar because I like experimenting new things too. And I'm glad you shared that memory about performing music in Christmas and being emotional, because it's also my favorite type of music during the whole year. Because for me, it's a time to get together with your family, with your friends, and unfortunately, my whole family is not in the States, but now I have my wife, so we spend time together. We make a turkey, now we are going to spend it with my little brother, who's not a little brother anymore. He's 25. But I love the sense of community that Christmas brings, and the food and the sweets, and on top of that, the music is just my favorite part. We appreciate your time today.
Gracias por escucharnos. Aprender sobre su rol en la comunidad y en Heartland Sings ha sido un placer. Recuerda seguirnos en las redes sociales y si disfrutó de nuestro contenido, por favor comparte con amigos y familia. Creemos en el poder de la música para cambiar vidas. Estamos localizados en Fort Wayne, Indiana, pero nos enfocamos en la comunidad global con programas de artes vocales, con eventos educativos, culturales y de entretenimiento. Gracias por escucharnos y recuerda venir a nuestros eventos con el RV en los barrios, Music from the Americas in the Fall, la Misa Criolla de Ariel Ramírez, Spirit of Christmas, the 10th anniversary this year, Jingle Bell Jazz y muchos más en diciembre. Learning about your journey, your role in our community and in Heartland Sings has been a pleasure. We believe in the power of music to change lives. We are based in Fort Wayne, Indiana, but we project ourselves to the global community through educational, cultural and entertainment programs of vocal arts. Thank you everyone for joining us and make sure to come to our shows in the RV, in your neighborhood or downtown. Music from the Americas in the Fall, Spirit of Christmas, the 10th anniversary, Jingle Bell Jazz in the winter, and the Opera Vocal Competition in the spring. If you want to read the script in English and Spanish, check out our website. Sing like the birds, because we are alive. Cantemos como los pájaros, porque estamos vivos. Thank you for listening, and we will meet next week. Gracias por escucharnos, y nos vemos la siguiente semana.